This is Channel 2 News, coverage you can count on.
Today at Hug High School, our students, teachers, and staff are back in classrooms, teaching and learning.
Hug High School is trying to get back to normal after a student armed with knives was shot by school police. District officials are offering support to students, but there are still some unanswered questions. And that is our Channel 2 News big story at 5 o'clock. You know, police are really urging everyone, though, to reserve judgment until after the investigation into this shooting is complete. Good evening, I'm Kristen Remington.
And I'm Landon Miller. Thank you for joining us tonight. Statements on social media from the student's father right now are raising a lot of questions. Zach Mooney took those concerns to the district today. And Zach, what did you find out?
Well, Landon, most importantly, we found that it's going to take a lot of time to get answers to these questions. We've seen a lot of debate on social media over the officer's use of force, along with the student's motive for pulling knives at school. And these details should come out once the investigation's over.
I would like to take this moment to commend our community and our families at Hug High School for remaining calm and supportive of our children during this very difficult time.
Superintendent Tracy Davis thanked everyone for their support after the incident at Hug High School. Wednesday, a school police officer shot a 14-year-old who was swinging a pair of knives at fellow students.
Had it not been for their quick actions and professionalism, I truly believe that the outcome could have been much worse for our students.
The student's dad took to Facebook, sharing his thoughts in a string of posts. He says school police should have used a taser rather than a gun, and that videos posted to social media support his claim.
Please remember that these accounts don't tell the complete story. This is an ongoing investigation, and as such, we will not be able to release any details.
And Reno police are investigating the incident, and its report will go to the district attorney for a review. The school police officers are all post-certified, which is a national standard for police officer training.
Upon the conclusion of this event, we will review all emergency procedures to ensure that we are providing the highest level of safety and security for all of our staff and students.
So as a parent, just watch for signs that your child may need additional support.
And the district has made counseling and mental health services available to everyone at Hug High School and district-wide. Meanwhile, the suspect was taken to the hospital in critical condition.
I will close that our heart goes out to the student involved and their families, as this is a difficult time for them also.
The suspect's dad also claims that his son brought those knives to school in response to bullying. While that is still under investigation, officials say that any bullying should be reported right away so that the district can respond.
Our school district is in constant, continuous improvement of our safe and respectful learning practices. And under the guidance of research and federal regulations and laws, we're continually reviewing that and supporting that.
Now for more on the counseling resources available, we've added a link for you at ktvn.com. Just click on that blue news links button. Now Superintendent Tracy Davis, along with Police Chief Jason Trevino, did not take questions after their statements due to the ongoing investigation. Covering the big story live in the newsroom, Zach Mooney, Channel 2 News.
All right, Zach, thank you. And as